Now we will see about the primary dysmenorrhea in adolescents. Adolescents are, as per WHO, the age from 11 to 19 years. Today's population, 22% of the populations are adolescents. Of this, 60 to 70% of the girls suffer from primary dysmenorrhea. What is this primary dysmenorrhea? They have pain during their menstruation, that is before the bleeding starts, 11 to 12 hours, and on the first day. Once the bleeding occurs, the pain is reduced. We have to exclude this from the secondary dysmenorrhea, where there is pathology in the uterus. In primary dysmenorrhea, we don't have pathology. It is due to the increased prostaglandins. So the main treatment for primary dysmenorrhea is counselling. We are doing the school counselling and we give the questionnaires of menstrual problems. Of this, 60% of the girls, they tick as S for the pain during menstruation. When we do the counselling two times, three times, after 6 months, if I give the same questions, the pain during menstruations, they are mentioning as around 30% has reduced. This is because of the counselling. They should not take leave from the school and they should be interested in whatever work they are doing. If it is not settled with the psychological problem, mild NSAID can be given as a treatment for primary dysmenorrhea. That is Tranexamic acid or Mefenamic acid, 500 milligram, OD or BD or TDS depending on the pain. If it is not reduced with NSAID, then you can go for the hormonal treatment. That hormonals can be given for 5 to 6 months. If it is not reduced even with this, then the secondary dysmenorrhea, any pathology present, has to be ruled out. But of all this, primary dysmenorrhea, mainly the counselling of adolescents is very, very important. And they should, lifestyle should be changed. They should have a good diet and proper exercises. All adolescents should do the sit-up at least 15 to 20 times per day. So the lifestyle modification is the main treatment for primary dysmenorrhea, and if at all needed, and mild NSAID can be given. Thank you.